I'm David Nieuwoud from the beautiful Cederberg Mountains. Welkom bij die Cederberg Christmas Party. We don't do this due to COVID or that the whole world goes online. We really make use of this opportunity to bring the Cederberg into your home tonight, that you can really share what we're doing on a daily basis up in the mountains. So in 10 minutes you will be up in the Cederberg. I'm here with a very good mate, Bertus Basson. Some of you might know him, some don't. Apparently he's a celebrity chef.
I always say celebrities don't work as hard as I do, so it's okay.
But so Bertus will show us how to prep our food, but I think it's more important is the wine tonight.
I fully agree. And yeah. It's about time that wine gets a bit of shine. Now, usually chefs are like the rock stars, but tonight it's your turn, David, you know?
Thanks. Grab a nice glass of Chenin.
Cheers.
So we will do the five generation Chenin. Towards the end of the concert, we will be actually in this vineyard. It's a very small, it's just 12 barrel selection, and it's a really beautiful wine, very perfumed, beautiful food companion. And then later we will do the Merlot Shiraz as well, the Cederberg Merlot Shiraz, one of my personal favorites.
Dude, everything you make is my personal favorite, to be honest with you.
Yeah, but I just love that wine. It's easy, it's refreshing, it's fruit-driven, really a fantastic wine. So guys, really sit down, relax. For those of you that's tonight in Welkom, that's guys in Harrismith, in Sandton, in Knysna, in Klerksdorp, in the northern parts, share this beautiful evening with us. Have some great fun. It was an amazing 2020, a challenging year, but with really some good outputs towards the end. Have an amazing Christmas and festive season and a fabulous 2021.
Superb.
Bertus, so, we need the course brand.
I'm going to try my best.
Cheers.
So you would have received this amazing box full of goodies, and in the box there would be two bottles of wine and then all of these things prepared for you. So the amazing thing is that you're not going to cook anything tonight, you're just going to enjoy it. The instructions are in the box, and I suggest you start getting everything ready about 45 minutes before you actually want to enjoy the meal. Now the first thing that you're going to have is a bit of bread. Now we've already lit this candle. This is an opposite cash. The candle is made from beef fat, flavored with a bit of onion ash, and as the candle burns down, you can take your little bread rolls and dip it into the beef fat and enjoy it like lard on toast, like fat on bread. It's delicious. David, if you want to have a quick taste.
Fantastic.
But if you don't dig the fat thing, there's also some green fig butter in the box. The figs come from my aunt in Ribe Castile, which is sort of on the cusp of your valley, which is quite cool and one of my favorite things.
This is amazing, sorry.
Yeah, it's delicious, huh? Like it's a beef
fat. It's a strange concept, but fantastic.
And then as your first course is a little semolina gnocchi bake with gammon. So you can't do like a Christmassy meal without gammon, I think, you know. And in South Africa, we're not really a sort of turkey people. We're pork and lamb people for Christmas. So it's quite cool. So this beautiful little bake of gnocchi, tomato, bit of gammon, lots of Huguenot cheese. It is delicious. And that's just going to be your first course. Now, that's where you start the meal. Now, when we move on, it's a little bit more happening. This is a slow-cooked lamb shoulder on the bone. Over Christmas time, I'm definitely a lamby sort of guy. So I love slow-roasted lamb shoulders and legs and things. It's delicious. And lamb rib is my ultimate thing. And with the lamb shoulder, we've made a little bit of gremolata, chopped lemon zest, garlic, and parsley. And you can just garnish your lamb shoulder with that. And what you do is you do this. And you can do it from sort of quite high and pretend like you're quite chefy.
Okay,
it's not necessary, but it's cooler.
And for it's all those delicious guys in Middleburg.
Yeah. Yeah. And then there's a little bit of like nut and seed granola that for the carrots. So we call these forgotten carrots. They're just like super slow roasted. And we know when fruit cooks so slowly, it condenses in flavor, delicious, sweet, yummy. Yeah. Slow cooked onions, a little bit of lamb jus, and then a little bit of granola. So that's like the ultimate sort of Christmassy meal.
Beautiful,
for me.
Eh?
Yeah, it's
look
amazing.
Look at that, fantastic, eh? So this one I can do with the Merlot Shiraz then?
100%.
And okay, so you must really move through the five generation Chenin to get to the Merlot Shiraz. Okay.
But and nice thing about this whole meal is the whole thing goes through the oven. Yeah. There's no cooking on the stove. You're doing nothing. You're just really reheating and enjoying it, and it's really cool. We've got a little potato bake and then some sweet potato pie. So that's your main course tonight. We're starting with bread, candle, butter, baked gnocchi, lamb shoulder, sweet potato pie, potato bake, and then dessert, obviously, which is a big thing. And in Stellenbosch, we're very lucky. We're surrounded by vineyards, obviously, which we love. And then also some strawberry farms. And this time of the year, we get strawberries from a very specific farm outside of Stellenbosch called Sumerbosch, our favorite strawberry farm. And all it is just this wonderful little strawberry crumble and a little bit of whipped mascarpone. So you dish up the crumble, have some mascarpone. If you're lucky enough, you've got a little bit of wine left, but there's also a great excuse not to crack out something sweet, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but you can actually open a third bottle of wine.
I fully agree.
Just put two in a box.
I fully agree.
Yeah.
I fully agree. And then if you don't have enough wine, you know, obviously know what to do and where to get the wine from.
Yeah.
So that's cool. So this is a delicious meal from my kitchen to your kitchen. It's a wonderful way to eat and just enjoy the evening and enjoy the wines. I think the wine's all spectacular. And if you come down to the Cape again, please go visit Daver on the Farm. If you haven't been to the Cedarburg yet, it's one of the most magical places in South Africa. Full of great wine, great beer, great company, good people.
And good attitude.
A good attitude, yeah. It's amazing.
Guys, you must really enjoy this fantastic evening. Bertus, thank you so much to put this beautiful show together for all the loyal Cedarburg ambassadors. And once again, thank you very much for all your support during the years and have a fantastic evening.
Cheers. Have a good Christmas.
Cheers. Merry Christmas.
It's the festive season, and for us as the Bottomless Coffee Band, we feel so honored to form part of the Cedarburg Wines Christmas celebration.
Sit back and enjoy the show with us. We're going to sing you songs and we're going to share you some stories. Hopefully this will rejuvenate you alongside your lovely glass of wine.
So we just came from a quick morning stroll and look at this fantastic landscape that we just arrived at. This place is called the Valley of the Red Gods. It's incredible.
On the outskirts of the Sundrift Holiday Resorts are these incredible rock formations that literally takes your breath away.
You know, and it also energizes one's soul, those landscapes, you know?
Just like your first cup of morning coffee.
All right. So the first song is called Morning Coffee. Here we go.
Wow. 2, 3.
Yes, I've learned to love the morning.
Which you actually have.
Well, I'm glad to tell you all the secrets that I keep.
Well, then please do so.
That I will join you for a morning coffee.
Yes.
You make me glad for all the whole wide world to see. Come on, let's go. Run forever far away. If you can share with me my morning coffee,
I'd be so happy for forever and a day.
Ta-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da
ons het besluit, dit is tijd voor ons eerste wijnkie bij Cederberg Wines. En ons sit op een rots, op een Kini Beach, langs die rivier in Sandrif.
Ja, so ons eerste wijn met ons vandaag gaan drinken is die Cederberg Sauvignon Blanc.
2020. Ons het nou vir mekaar gesê, hierdie jaar was misschien gebruik, maar hierdie wijne is heel.
Ja. Kan ik je skink, Kirsten?
Baie dankie.
So, hierdie is dan ook die wijne wat jullie vanavond in jullie glas het. Die lieflijke Cederberg Sauvignon Blanc 2020.
Wat interessant is van hierdie wijn is, in die Weskaap is dit van die wingerd wat die heel hoogste bo seespieël groei. En wat jy jouself nou kan indink om gauw te verstaan hoe hoog dit is, is Tafelberg. So verbeel jou
ja,
een wingerd
so
bo op Tafelberg.
850 na
1000 meter bo seespieël. Daarom is hierdie so ongelooflike unieke Sauvignon Blanc. En ek en Laurens sê altyd, ons moet eers ruik wat ons ruik en dan mag ons die etiket lees om te kyk of ons enigszins iets kon regkry.
Ek dink gebruiklik aan Sauvignon Blanc, hy is baie crispy.
Mm.
Dus dit laat my vrolijk voel.
Ja, en ek ruik fijn van een of ander aard. Ek sê seker of het ryp of groen is nie. Ik
denk dat voor mij baie uniek is van Cederberg wijnen. The fact that it is so high with wines with high altitude, it is very lively.
Yes. And, yes, the wine that we've had before of Cederberg is definitely it always comes
it's
alive very, in your mouth.
Yeah, it's refreshing.
And, yes, refreshing. Mm, that is a good word. Okay, let's taste. Mm. Wat my brein sê is onmiddellik nog, wat 'n goeie ding is.
Absoluut.
Dit is so vars en levendig in 'n mens se mond.
Ja.
Dit pas perfek by hierdie strand setting.
Ja, absoluut.
Mm. Okay, Laurens, ek gaan vir ons lees of ons enigszins iets in orde gehad het. So dit sê wines with altitude, which we think is a very smart wordplay because it's also wines with attitude. For 5 generations, the Nivard family has been handcrafting wines from the highest lying vineyards in the Cape Winelands. So, Sauvignon Blanc 2020 is a refreshing Sauvignon Blanc showing notes of gooseberry. Didn't get that one. Well, I'm sure it's there. My wine kennis is net the min. Lemongrass? Yes! Okay, And a hint of green fig!
Yeah,
yay!
So, if you had to pair this wine, waarmee sal jy graag hierdie wine wil paar?
Goeie geselskap.
Amen.
Nog meer lang somerdae.
Absoluut.
No, but in all honesty, I would actually set up a little braai right here and I will cook beautiful seafood. I think that is just perfect.
Yeah, that sounds great. In fact, that sounds like a plan.
It makes me feel that I want to be in an endless summer. I want to laugh with good friends.
Yeah. I want to see the sunset with this wine in my hand.
Met 'n prawn en 'n kalamarietjie wat daar geraak iewers op 'n pan.
But also, I won't mind seeing the sunrise with this wine in my hand as well.
Oh, yeah. It's beautiful. And this last line says, a full-flavored wine with a crisp finish. And I think that is absolutely perfect.
Yeah.
So, what an
honor.
One
thing that is very unique that I feel about the Cederberg wines in general, because they are so high in altitude, nothing can really compare.
Yes.
It is so unique that it's a distinguishing factor.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So it's an honor for us.
That's why you have that lively mouthfeel.
Yes.
And the crispness.
To drink this wine today is simply amazing. And I think this Cederberg range is definitely something that we need in our glasses more often.
Absolutely. So these Sauvignon Blanc grapes, I've just been told, they grow in the sandstone, and this is a little piece of sandstone, and just imagine the vineyards living in between these sandstone rocks.
En is daar nie die mooie ding van wingerd nie, nee?
So dankbaar, hè?
Wingerd is dankbaar, dit kan groei eintlik in haglike omstandighede met baie hitte en baie sand en swaarkry omstandighede, maar dan kry jy hierdie absolute
kunst.
Crisp, pragtige, lively art in a bottle and in your mouth.
Amen daarop. Ek dink kom ons gaan maak op musiek. Gesondheid.
Hoeveel keer in jou lewe kry jy die geleentheid om by Bikini Beach te sit by Cederberg wyne en 'n lieflike glasie Sauvignon Blanc te drink? Ons is vir nou eers weer op pad na die keller toe vir die volgende stop, die kelderkonsert.
We are in the heart of the Cedarburg Wines, in the cellar. And we have the great honor to perform a few songs here today where the lifeblood of the Nouveau family flows. And it goes without saying that 2020 was probably one of the most colorful and challenging years for most of us. And this next song really paints the picture of that the grass is not always greener on the other side. Jy weet, mens dink so vinnig dat as ek net iewers anders kan uitkom of iewers anders kan wees in my lewe, gaan alles anders wees. But this song is really about embracing the journey that we're on and understanding that life might sometimes feel so broken, but we are survivors. And that's beautiful. The song is called Broken System.
Sits a boy with no shoes on. He's never seen the sea or mountains. With a cracked old bucket and a dirty brush, he says, "Excuse me, can I wash your window?" I turn away with hasty eyes. My mother gone, my father nameless. His whole life is but survival, fighting for dignity. The coins he has won't take him through the snow.
Weet jy, Jesse, ons is nou inderdaad in die Cederberge en ek besef net, ek kry ook nou nogals warm. So, ek gaan my boekie uittrek.
Dis reg, Lou. Ek voel nou weer dat siende ons hier in die hartklop van hierdie prachtige plek is, voel ek ons moet huildronk instel. And I think this year's festive time is just so much more special because people can understand
really understand what they are cheersing on. I remember when it was still hard lockdown, people would say how I miss my people and my family and to have everyone around me. And there's nothing more beautiful for us than having our family and friends on a long table with a glass of wine in hand and just celebrating life. So I think that is exactly what we must do now.
Absolutely. With that being said, I think it's just fit that we raise a glass for all of you out there as well. Mag 2020 sterk vir ons eindig. Mag die metsnoere vir ons op mooie plekke val. And may 2021 be our best year yet.
There we go.
Gesondheid op die lewe. Gesondheid.
Is this eindelijk, is lovely.
Dis eindelijk onregverdig hoe lekker hierdie is.
Dis eindelijk oorweldigend. Ons gaan later so 'n bietjie meer oor die wyn gesels.
Ja.
For now, all you have to know is it is delicious.
Absolutely.
The next song is a blues number, Adler.
Yes.
So we were very, very fortunate to travel to the United States in January of 2020. And I think there we really felt what the true heart of the blues is.
Of the blues was, yes. I actually wrote this song when I was 19. And I've been a fond listener of blues music. But blues het eerst my regtig begin sin maak toe ons aand in Memphis spandeer het. And there's a street, it's called Beale Street. And in Beale Street, you have to go and experience the blues clubs. What happens is you literally travel from the one bar to the next one. And you go in and you listen to the musicians. Every bar is exceptional. And every musician is exceptional. And blues music was birthed out of people coming together to experience wholesomeness. Dit is gebore uit 'n plek van swaar kry waar mense om 'n sirkel sou kom staan, hulle sorges sou deel en sou sing daaroor en beter voel daarna. En ek dink dis 'n soortgelyke ervaring wat in my lewe gebeur het toe ek hierdie sang geskryf het. Ek glo nogals vas daarin. Ons kan, as ons deur die moeilikheid uitgaan, wil ons graag die antwoorde gaan soek in die wêreld. En die wêreld gaan nie vir jou wêreldse antwoorde gee, jy weet, maar as jy jou antwoorde gaan vind op die regte plek, die ware bron, dan kry mens ware antwoorde. So, in my geval het ek opgegaan naar die berg toe, ek het stil geword en ek het op my knie neergeval. So, hierdie song is Up to the Mountain. Gaan ons.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Lawrence Robbie on the guitar.
Thank you so much.
While we were singing that song now, I thought how absolutely beautiful it was when we went up to the mountain this morning on this incredible farm. So to celebrate nature also, I feel is so integral with Cederberg wines, and everyone's heart here, you can hear, beats for nature just as much as for all the other incredible stuff that's happening here. So it's beautiful to see that. The next song
Said, I always feel when you play a blues song,
you need to cheers.
It pairs perfectly with a red wine. Gezondheid op die blues.
Gezondheid op blues in rooi wijn pairing. So if you have red wine in your glass at home, then you are welcome to also cheers on the blues.
Yes. So this next song is called Mr. Selfishness. And Mr. Selfishness is kind of my life story. To a certain extent. Voordat ons voltijdse muzikanten was, het ons onszelf gevind in die coöperatieve sector eerst. Ik was een beleggingsanalist geweest voor 4 jaar. En growing up, you know, you have this dream in your head that you want to do one day. Voor sommige mensen is dit om een dokter te wees of ingenieur of waar het ook al mag wees. And then you find yourself in the normal life, doing your 8-to-5 or whatever it may be, and then you realize, hey, maar ek dink nie, ek is nie besig om my droom te volg hierdie. And I firmly believe if all of us can do what we love and love what we do, the world will just be a better place. En ek sit toe op gedurende werksure en ek skryf toe hierdie volgende song op 'n spreadsheet.
Kan ek net vir julle noem, maar ek skryf nog steeds elke ander song ook op 'n spreadsheet.
Ja, is lekker goed uitgeorden. And really, what Mr. Selfishness says is, if you didn't follow your dream, you're actually being selfish with yourself. So, bietjie van 'n selfonderzoek geweest, cabaret-style song, om nie selfsugtig te wees teenoor jouself en eerder jou drome te gaan volg.
And I feel in the context of what we see here at Cederberg Wines, Lowe, where it's really
absolutely
a family-owned wine farm.
And they have intense passion for the brand and for the wines.
Can you imagine how many times you had to go, I'm still following the dream, and that makes it beautiful.
And really reassess and rebirth that dream constantly. Yes. So here is for Cederberg Wine. Mr. Selfishness, here we go.
Thank you.
traveling to and fro. I've seen some bloody rivers flow, but it was not too good to see. I have seen kings and horses fall to one that single selfish call, but it was not satisfactory. And when the evening fades and a new dawn plays upon your face because I'm sitting next to you, come on in, look a little closer and listen a little clearer, what's my name? I'm Mr. Selfishness himself. I am the selfishness itself. I have been traveling every town. I've been notoriously renowned for that. Gonna false decree. Believe that fate will be your neighbor and that force will be your savior, but it ends in misery. That when the evening fades, not a new dawn lays upon your face. I'm sitting next to you. Come on in, look a little closer and listen a little clearer. What's my name? I'm Mr. Selfishness himself. I am the selfishness itself.
You are the selfishness
itself. It was the selfishness itself. The selfishness himself.
Ladies and gentlemen, we present to you Nappies, or actually Napoleon.
He is the unofficial mayor of Cedarburg Wines. Many a tourist and love him and have tried to steal him.
Yes, but he only ever loves you if you have a snack.
That's it. Nappies, het is een voorrecht om in jouw gezelschap te wees.
Hij zal ook besluiten wanneer hij gaan gaan. Zo ons kan maar voortgaan.
He might join us for the next song. We will see if he leaves. We greet you goodbye. So the next song is called Folsom Prison Blues. And this is a cover from Johnny Cash that we so dearly love. When we started the band, Bottomless Coffee Band, we were still two students from Stellenbosch. And we had this mutual love for Johnny Cash music. And what we would try to do is we would take Johnny and June songs and we would try to cover them and make them our own. Put our own kind of flair on the songs. And this was the very first song that we ever performed together. It's called Folsom Prison Blues.
And I think it's such a beautiful thing to always remain true to your roots, you know? And if we think about roots, it goes in many different directions. Lawrence grew up in Durbanville and I grew up in Graaffreinet, and our music started in Stellenbosch with Johnny Cash. And to always celebrate that, to always remember where something came from is so beautiful and so precious. So this is Folsom Prison Blues, and we hope you are still having a great time with us on this beautiful, beautiful concert where we can showcase and present to you this incredible family and farm.
Thank you. the line, no weapon for false prison. That's where I want to stay.
That's where I want to stay.
And I let that lonesome whistle. Blow my blues out.
Okay, everyone, it is time to talk a little bit about this beautiful wine that we have been drinking throughout this set in the cellar.
We are so excited about this beautiful wine, perfect for Christmas. So let's read what the label says.
We mentioned the wine we are drinking is a Ciderberg Shiraz. This has to be one of the most exquisite Shirazes I've had in ages.
It's beautiful.
It is simply amazing. This is a Ciderberg Shiraz 2018.
It's beautiful, and to be honest with you, if I smell this, I smell Christmas. I smell Christmas.
Yes,
en die geure, eintlik, jy weet, partykeer dink ek, ons konsep van Kersfees is ons maar eintlik gevorm deur winters en sneeu en warm disse en Kersfeeskoeke and that is what I smell in here. And actually,
there's a lot of complexity on this wine,
yes,
but it is so soft.
Yes, and I would love to have this, yes, with Christmas, but also when it's cold by a kacheltjie, sal mens net sit en voor jy weet, is daar geen meer Cederberg Shiraz oor nie, en dan wil jy nog een oopmaak.
Absolute. And once again, the fact that it is high altitude wines, the grapes remains on the grapevines for longer. So there is actually more flavors that was extracted.
Fantastic, and that's why it's so soft and so beautiful. So this high altitude thing is really, really working so beautifully for these wines.
Kan jy 'n bietjie van die fynbos selfs opdra? Jy kan dit reg van die omgewing kry.
I know, the exact smell that we got this morning in the velds in the early morning is in this wine. It's so beautiful.
Hier is 'n tipe wyn wat ek vir myself wil koop en eintlik met mense wil deel nie.
Sien hierdie wyn.
Ek moet dit nie sê nie. Ek sê maar ek trek dit terug. Ek sal dit met almal wil deel.
Dis wat hierdie een is. Hy maak mense die mekaar, want soveel soos wat jy hom alleen voor jou kaggeltjie wil sit en opdrink, soveel wil jy 'n tafel vol vriende om hom mee te deel.
Absoluut.
Beautiful, complex, multifaceted, yet so super soft. So this label says, Shiraz 2018, a combination of cherries and black currants with a hint of spice. An elegant yet full-bodied wine with a velvety finish on the palate. A Shiraz with stature. I love it.
Gesondheid.
Gesondheid. Op lewe.
Gesondheid.
It's not often that you find a place where you feel so welcome like we do at Ciderberg Wines. We are treated to a beautiful lunch with the family and with the people of this valley. And it's not only the wines and the Sundrift Holiday Resort of this place that is beautiful. It's also the hearts of these beautiful people. Dis net op die plaas waar jy na middagete 'n paar dames op viole teekom. En ek het sommer ingeval op die klavier om vir julle iets baie spesiaal te doen. Kyk, die talent in hierdie vallei loop hoog.
Thank you.
David het namiddag het vir ons genooi om saam met hom op 'n wingerdstapie te gaan. En ons sien dit toe as 'n geleentheid om nog 'n lieflike botteltjie wyn oop te maak en natuurlik vir julle ietsie kraakvers daarmee saam te gee.
Julle hierdie dag raak net al hoe beter. Ons was nou baie bevoorreg om 'n wingerdwandel te kon doen saam met die uwe David en ons proe ook nou 'n verskriklike spesiale wyn, die Nieuwoud 5 Generations Chenin Blanc.
Hierdie is verskriklik mooi, hè?
En so spesiaal.
Ja, soos die 2018 vintage. So 2018 was 'n fantastiese witwynjaar, baie aromatiese jaar. Dit het hierdie skoon, amper kliniese wyne voortgebring, maar dit is verskriklik aromaties en het die mooiste mondgevoel. En dis wat die wyn so spesiaal maak. So, dis die eerste wingerd wat my oupa geplant het in 1972 in die Cederberg. Wow. En vandag is dit nou nie meer van die ou oorspronklike wingerd nie. Dit is van een van die wingerde die reg agter ons.
Oh, wow.
En dit is net in hierdie absolute pragtige landskap. En as jy kyk na al hierdie mooie blare, hoe gezond dit is. En dit is een baie hooggeleë wingerd, so 1000 meter bo seevlak.
Yes,
maar dit geef jou net ongelooflike mooie Chenin konsentrasie.
Yeah.
So hierdie doen ons heeltemal natuurlik. So is natuurlike gisting, heel tros, gepres, eindelijk minimum interference, soos die Engelsman zou gesê het, en dis wat het so uniek maak. So, op neus, en dan gaan het natuurlijk naar vate toe, so dat natuurlijke gisting in Franse eikevate, vir plus minus 9 maanden, en dit is wat die mooie neus vandaan kom. So, het ruikt so amper so oorryp limoenskil, neetachtig.
Lekker
sag en elegant. Ja, so bietjie voller, soos hulle sê, en een bietjie glycerol, bietjie vetachtig, maar die, ek dink die mooiheid van hierdie wijn, dit is so mooi afgerond op palet. Dit is soos murg, hè? En dit is die mooiheid van dit. Dit is soos sagte elegantie. En dit is die wijn wat julle vanaand drink. Dit is die 5 Generations 2018. So julle beter elke druppel geniet, want hierdie goed is regtig mooi.
Dit is absoluut pragtig hierdie. En om hierdie nou te kan inneem in hierdie omgewing. I mean, hierdie is asemrowend en hierdie is julle agterplaas.
Dit is so die pragtige deel van die plaas eintlik ook, ja.
Yes.
En wat vir my ook so besonder is om te dink dat dit so 'n aflosstokkie was al deur die jare wat generasie na generasie net vir mekaar aangegee is en ek dink om daai geskiedenis vas te vang in julle kuns wat julle maak is net baie besonder.
Ag, en dis 'n lekker deel, dis ook 'n lekker deel van 'n familieplaas, jy weet, en so ons het so baie loyale ondersteuners want jy weet ons gaan nêrens heen nie. En dis 'n lekker deel van dit. So jy moet elke druppel verskriklik baie geniet.
Maar die wyne is van uitstaande gehalte, die smaak is buitengewoon lekker. 'N groot ding wat 'n kenmerkende eienskap aan julle wyne is die feit dat dit so hoog bo seevlak is. Wat presies doen dit aan julle wyne?
Kyk, hoogte bo seevlak gee jou baie groot verskil tussen dag en nagt temperature. So dit is ook ons grootste nadeel is ryp.
Okay.
Maar jy het 'n baie lang rypwordingsperiode. So die druiwe raak baie stadiger ryp, so jy het baie meer geur akkumulasie, jy het baie op rooi spesifiek baie sagter tanienstrukture. So dis 'n massiewe groot voordeel is die verskil tussen dag en nagt temperatuur. En dan natuurlik kom jy geen wingersiektes voor nie. Want ek het nog een vrotkorrel in 22 jaar op hierdie plaas gesien nie. En dit is hoekom ons sulke verskriklike mooi skoon witwyne spesifieke maak. As jy kyk na die kleur ook, jy weet dit so hierdie mooi beautiful wit, amper groen tint.
Absoluut.
Maar dit is so mooi aromaties en dit is wat dit so lekker maak.
Dit is regtig besonder.
David, as jy nou hierdie wyn drink, wat wil jy moet ander mense dink van hulle jou wyn drink?
Heel eerste moet hulle elke druppel geniet, né? Maar my famous quote is altyd te sê, I want to if people must drink this wine and think of these mountain ranges. They're unique and untouched.
Oh.
Kan ek vir jou nog
een bietjie skink? Daarop.
Dit is so besonder.
Dankie.
En nou, terwyl jy so nog van hierdie kuns vir ons skink, wil ek graag weet of daar 'n spesifieke staaltjie of story of iets is wat jy aan kan dink wat regtig vir jou besonder is van hierdie familieplaas.
Ek dink my oupa, hè. Hy was 'n baie ou pionier. En ek het nogal baie by hom geleer ook. En het was eintlik altyd baie lekker. Mense het vir hom gelag toe hy begin wingerd plant het hierso. Dit was hy het met skape en tabak geboer. Toe begin hy met vrugte. En toe eventueel in die 60er jare met tafeldruiwe. En om hier te boer is, jy moet toch, hulle sê altyd, is net 'n nieuwoud wat hier sal oorleef. en dis eintlik die lekker deel. So, hy was 'n baie groot inspirasie in my lewe gewees. Okay. Ek dink jy is so trots gewees vir vandag om te sien hoe mooi wyn ons hier produseer. En dit is vandag 100% net 'n wynplaas. En, sjo, hulle bly my uniek en, en mooi en skoon. So.
En natuurlijk die heritage word gereflecteer in die five.
Oh, ja, dit is nou, ek is die vijfde generatie op die plaas, en dit is maar waar die naam vandaan kom, is die eerste wingerd wat geplant is, en die vijf generaties soos...
Ongelooflik. Dit is vir ons 'n ongelooflike voorreg gewees, om die, saam met julle te kan kuier, om jou wijn te kan drink, en te kan ervaar in die landskap. Die is lewensveranderend vir my gewees.
Dit is regtig
ek dink as ons hier wegry, gaan ons smag hierna. Ons gaan wel terugkom, en ek dink dit is die gevoel wat allemaal buite sal hê. Maar weet jy, hierdie wijn is net te goed hierdie, om
dit,
self
dit
te
nuttig. Dit raak mooier in die glas. Dit is wat so mooi is. Ons het regtig allemaal gespoil vanavond om hierdie wijn vir julle ooral in julle huise te kry. Dit is ons vlaggenskip wijn, en net om hierdie 18 te drink ook, is so bietjie ouer, en die wijn moet jy nie drink as hy jonk is, hy moet so bietjie ouer ook raak. Okay. Dis ook om het so beautiful is op palet ook.
So sag, so elegant.
Ek skim sommer vir my ook nog een bietjie.
Doen dit.
Maar weet jy, hierdie is, ek gaan eerlijk wees, hierdie wijn is te goed om nie te deel nie.
Ons gaan moet deel.
Luister, Benny, wil jy een stukkie hê?
Hier is een span wat hierdie by mekaar sit. Stukke goeie goed, moet gedeel word.
Luister, kerels.
Kom aan, manne. Dit is so lekker om net seker mooi wijn op so mooi prachtige aand te drink.
Dit is besonder en een mens vier die lewe Corrie. In sy volheid.
Corrie, wat gaat jy?
Corrie, well done,
hè? Yes, broers.
Corrie, cheers, hè?
Gezondheid,
op die lewe.
Op lewe, op legacy.
En op 2020, hè? Dit was so mooi jaar gewees, ook, met uitdagings en alles. En uiteindelijk so uit een prachtige einde. So.
Absoluut.
Cheers.
En hoor.
Cederberg Wines.
Gezondheid.
Op
lewe. Is hy Benny?
Benny, jy het hard gewerkt. Kom aan.
Hoe lekker, hè?
Corrie, jy lyk so stichtelik, so ons kan maar met jou een lekker glaasie deur sê vandag, hè? En dankie vir julle moeite, dit is so lekker om julle hier bo in die Cederberge te hê. Hierdie plek is baie na in ons hart, en het is net fantastisch om het met allemaal te deel vanavond ook, hè? Dit is een lekker lekker deel. So.
Ons mag ook nie huis toe gaan.
Nee, ons
nie, ek weet julle het gister
ons blij achter. Ons blij tot die volgende pars, en dan val ons maar sommer in.
To be king, to be sire, from the giver of life, another piece of life. We are born.
Muziek, wijn, gezelligheid, gesprekken. In this valley a special heart beats, the heart of people coming together. And as the sun sets on this beautiful day, we know that we experience something special.
Dank je voor de gastvrijheid. Dit is voor ons erg een groot voorrecht om te kunnen deel wees hiervan. Jullie zijn amazing, amazing plaats. Jullie zijn amazing mensen. Jullie gastvrijheid is ongelooflijk.
En, amazing span.
Amazing span, great mensen. En die wijn, ik ben second to none. Dat is erg incredible. So, dit is erg een voorrecht.
Luister van lachen, fijn en weg kwijt, maar het blijft zo bitter uit. Een handkraai, dit was nog een lang nacht. Ik trek aan een bloempatroene, maar alles blijft zo bitter blauw.
Ik wil nog een zin voor jou schrijven, je leven heeft een punt gemaakt. Ik wil nog een pijn weer voor jou koop. Mars op je vloer. Ik wil nog niet 10 keer redeneer. Strijd door dat een slag. Nog een keer die zon zien opkom. Die leven heeft een punt gemaakt. Maar ik bloei 1000 woorden. Ik denk van dit is donker. En dit is donker want ik denk. Een korte tijd, maar voor eeuwig is zo lang. Ik ben al die goeikies van jou, maar het blijft zo bitter aan. Ik wil nog een zin van jou schrijven. Die leven heeft een punt gemaakt. Het pijn die ik voor je koop, die mos op je vloer. Ik wil nog niet 10 keer redeneer, strijd door het ontslag. Nog een keer de zon zien opkom, die leven heeft het punt gemaakt. Gezin voor jou schrijf, die leven heeft een punt gemaakt. Ik voel nog een painting voor je koop, die een moos op je vloer. Ik voel nog een 10 keer in en neer, strijd door het ontslag. Nog een keer die zon zien opkom. Die leven heeft een punt gemaakt.
Well, that sums it up from our side. We were the Bottomless Coffee Band, and it's been an incredible honor to entertain you. May you have a very lovely, Merry Christmas.